in terms of sounds, I call them unidentifiable. They're like UFOs, but they're in sound. You don't really know what they are. I'm playing with augmented reality, actually. I pitch my own voice. People are like, who's that guy? It's like me. And in terms of visuals, I'm also want to play with reality, because that's what it is. Where's elsewhere? Where's here? Where's there? Where are we? What time is it? Don't you ever make just save her so sad.
The background noise and no voices to camouflage my very self.
I think you see a continuity with what I do. Actually, it's probably all connected to dub, which is sound, texture, space and time. I think in everything I do, even in the music I made with my band Jacuzzi and what I do now, you can see that that plays quite a big role. So a lot of that comes from actually, in a way, living in London, because so much kind of Jamaican music has been mixed in with British culture that it's just automatic, you know? A lot of club energy within me, but I tend to put that into DJing right now. I really enjoy DJing and I play completely different music to what I produce, and I feel very free doing that because in a way I come from club music, but I don't really want to have to produce that. I don't really want to make a club project where I kind of always have to think about the dance floor. And so with Perera Elsewhere, I've created a project where I can make stuff which is dancier. There are tracks like Tomorrow's House, which are dancier, or Girl from Monotronica, which is just synths and 808s and stuff. But I don't have to make a whole album like that. I can basically make whatever I want. It can be experimental, it can be slightly dancey, I can also make songs. Come on, shine with me. And you say what you wanna. I said I wanna keep up with me. When I was a kid and I went to massive sound system parties and saw people just freaking out to this music, it did remind me of religion, you know? It's like a substitute of religion. It's also going elsewhere, you know? I like hypnotic music, you know? There's hypnotic club music and there's also hypnotic non-quantized music. I make pretty psychedelic, hypnotic, unquantized music with organic and synthetic elements, if you want, you know? Creating my own kind of format of spirituality, if you want, you know? The way I choose percussion, for example, I went to the London Philharmonic Orchestra website and they've got loads of free sounds you can use. They've got sheep's toenails, which they've recorded. So I'm using sheep's toenails as percussion. Nobody knows that. When they listen to my track on Pitchfork or whatever, they don't know that, but I know that. And I know that there's an animal inside my music. You know, I forget about it afterwards, not every time I think about it, but it's in the process. There are just little things which all these details of coincidence and chance have a form of spirituality for me. All right, so you see me here in the studio. I record in the studio sometimes, but I also, when I go away, I take gear with me and I'll record just somewhere in a weird room, somewhere in a hotel, in a cupboard, in the rainforest. I leave the windows open because some of that sound leakage, I like it because it's like showing what is happening in that moment. You can't remove it afterwards. It's not something you choose to add. Okay, let me just add like wind or birds. It's already in the audio recording, and there's something about that space and the sound leakage from the other rooms or whatever, which it sounds stupid, but I'm looking for some form of spirituality, I guess. I'm faking it. I'm looking at it for myself. Join me if you want, you know?
I can't walk in your shoes. Can't speak, I can't move. So deep in this mindful, I'm living inside.
When I produce a track, okay, so I often start with some kind of chords because I might want to write a song on it. If I want to write a song, I'll start with some chords. I don't even know what key it's in. I just know it all works together. I play lots of instruments, but I don't think about chord progressions or cadences or what keys all fit together. I just go with what I work with. And often I record stuff and I hate 90% of it. And I take the tiny bit I like and I loop it and I use technology actually to inspire me. I'm like, okay, I don't really like that like this, but what if I pitch it and put it through tons of different effects and put some Max for Live in it? It's like, oh, now it's completely different. And I think I work out of error. I'm autodidact, I taught myself this stuff. I studied European politics in German. I wasn't supposed to do this. I just started buying gear and actually had a starting point where I was like, well, you know, even doing this is already an achievement. When I play live, I'm actually experimenting in a lot of ways. I play with a drummer, I play with a bass player, I play with visuals. I've made all of my visual content, most of it, with a good friend of mine, Hugo Holger Schneider, who I've known for like 15 years. And we made 3 videos, a video trilogy, and turned some of that stuff into visuals. So I see the performance is definitely connected to some of the stories that are going on within the visuals and within the whole language and context of the album and the music I made. I mean, why am I called Perera Elsewhere, right? I kind of don't want to be here all the time. It's kind of shitty out there, you know? I have to be here. So I have to find this other kind of way to at least express myself and to connect with other people who feel the same. Also politically and musically, that they just want to find some kind of other. Also as a place of refuge, but also, yeah, for creativity. I think actually creativity is maybe, yeah, it's like a saving thing, you know? So everything else is so consumption oriented. I'm like, okay, yeah, of course, you also have to sometimes consume stuff too. You might have to buy a guitar to write a song, you know? But it's, you can create community and life from that. That's kind of my elsewhere thing. And yeah, what was the question? Slipping away, slipping away, slipping away.